close and imagine your heart that you are taking food and the food is going, just imagine inside your mind. All realizations, they start with the dreams, then dreams are translated into imaginations. Imaginations result in realizations. Imaginations, for truthful things, they are realizations. Mere imagination is an air castle and nobody can reside inside it. And just consume some food. And don't concentrate about the variety of food because you will be diverted. So just some food is taken inside, it reaches your canal, the intestine, everything is sucked and made into a fluid in the form of rasa, and that rasa that gives you that essence, quintessence of the nutrition that gives you energy, that energy is transmitted into all parts of the body by the heart, and this is done by God or the divine spirit inside. Now you have got 2% of energy to cure heart diseases. By analyzing this thing with life, study everything with life, thinking that the heart is some package inside your body, think that heart is everything, that is life. Whenever you deal with any part of the body, either it is in urology, nephrology, gynecology, pediatrics, neurology, neuropsychology, neuropsychiatry, neurochemistry, neurobiology, neuroontology, neurometry, whatever may be the science, the concept of thing must be treated as God. Think it as universal form. Think it as a complete form. Then you will get energy. Now, if you have thought in the simpler process which I have told, 2 marks you have got for healing. This is enough for getting 2 marks. So, this physical governance is done by heart. Number 2, emotional governance. More than the emotional governance, the emotional sequential order and impact, it is an emotional reactant. We cannot say that the heart creates emotions. It is evolved from the mind. The sukshma akasha inside, it is known as dharakasha. I want to just clarify one thing from Brahma Sutra, and somebody, they raise one prima facie question to Vedavyasa, where is the place for soul? There is nothing known as soul. If there is soul, is it a component of a compound or a compound full of components? It is neither a compound with components nor a component for a particular compound. It is a separate, a distinct element. So, if there is such a distinct element, and how does it reside inside the body and activate? And I have discussed in one genetical engineering seminar about the place of soul. What happens to soul at the time of pregnancy? How your second soul gets inside? And what is in the spermatology, the dealing with souls where there is multitude? And what happens to soul at the time of cloning? And what is the connection between DNA and soul? So, these things are discussed in genetic engineering, these things. So, likewise, the Vyasa says, Hridihi, just note down the soul. Hridihi, the soul is there in Hrid, that is in the heart portion. Then somebody, they ask some question, if soul is inside the heart, then now they are making pacemaker, they are making cardiac surgery, and they are making artificial heart and artificial operations also. At the time of this, how the heart will function, and soul must be in such a position where it cannot be touched at all, and if it is there just within a freshy package which is being operated by modern surgeon, it is not acceptable. So the Shastra says that Hridaya is of 2 types. One is Hridaya, the name of the Hridaya is because it is named after the Akasha, the ether inside, the Chidakasha inside. Do you know that? For example, there are lot of things like Tilak University, which is named after Tilak. Likewise, Hridaya is name of the Dharakasha, the ether inside. It is a space, it does not consist of anything that is fleshy, anything that is materialistic, it is paramaterialistic, impalpable realm, which is known as ether. In Sanskrit, it is known as Chidakasha or Dharakasha. For that, 1 mark for you. In that place, the soul resides, and everybody is asking, then if it is at one place, how it can activate the whole body? Aviro Adhashandaravat. This is the second sutra. There is no contradiction like chandana. Chandana, when applied to a particular portion, the chillness is conducted throughout the body. Likewise, by the Dharma Bhuta Jnana, by its radiation, Varagra Deepavat, like the light is placed in one particular place which cannot permeate, but it can permeate with its radiation. The tube light, it cannot permeate, but the fluorescence from the tube light, it can permeate within the whole system. Likewise, the soul being residing in the Dharakasha, it can permeate the whole body and activate as per the shastras. Avirodha Chandanavat is the second sutra. So now we have to understand that Hridaya is the name of the Akasha ether inside, and there also it is having one more tool. That one more tool is known as internal organ, mana. If it thinks, it is known as mind. If it decides, it is known as intellect. And if it makes a vow to act at the time of action and activation, it becomes a chitta and ahankara. You think, that is mind. You design, that is known as intellect. You confirm it, that is known as chitta. When you are having your altruistic egoism to execute it, that is known as ahankara, then you execute it. So before execution, pre-action phenomena consider four stages. One is conception, second is designing, third is planning, and fourth is determination or will to execute, fifth is execution. Somebody is seeing a silver bowl inside. This is a silver bowl, it is mind. The silver bowl is 2000 rupees, this is the intellect. Why can't we have it? That is chitta, suggestive mode. Yeah, you can have it, this is ahankara. Then you are just taking it and you are doing a very great kleptographic design to keep it inside your pant or somewhere else, and you are just moving the place out. Like that. There is a predetermination stage in thought. So this Dharakasha consists of soul. Soul vivifies the mind and other internal organs, then it reflects in heart. So heart is the impact, it is the impact organ of all emotions. Whenever you feel happy, whenever you are afraid, whenever you are in perplexity, whenever you are in anxiety, whenever you are in turmoil, whenever you are in confusions, at various stages of your mind, the heart responds by increasing its palpitation, by oozing out in the form of perspiration, by stimulating and scintillating you in the form of haripilation. So if all of these emotional outbursts are managed by heart, so heart is the substratum of your emotional things. Okay, now you just close your eyes and then just listen to what I say. I have told it in a very elucidator manner. Let me brief it. First, there is, you know, the heart. You must have seen in all pictures and other things. There is a small, lustrous, resplendent, sukshma akasha ether inside, and that is what we call the peripheral center of consciousness is anahata, and the deeper inside is Dharakasha. Between the package of Anahata and Dharakasha, there is Atma, Mana, Buddhi, Chitta, Ahankara, that we will decide later. First, you are seeing a resplendent ether, a space, which has nothing but light. And there is a small spark with infinite glory and with infinite transcendental effulgence, Prakasha. Swayam Prakasha, Sarvajna, Chidatmaka, Anandamaya. We are seeing that spark. And that spark is connected with mind. Mind, you give form to mind, it is known as personification. You give form to mind. Whenever you are giving forms to formless things, that is for easy apprehension, adaptability and transmission, and that is not a fertile imagination or mere hallucination. If something really exists, giving form to something which does not exist, it is fertile imagination and useless. It is existing, but the form is either not available, or it is too crucial to determine it, or it is totally invisible, or the form is too subtle, you personify with form. You imagine the Dharakasha and a spark of the soul, and also a spark, a subtle spark of mind. You imagine a big dot, from which one dot comes, that dot is rotating, that is known as the capricious mind. Then that capricious rotating mind is fixed in an orbit, that is an intellect. Within the orbit it proceeds, that is known as a determination chitta. Then it oozes out in the form of action, either by seeing through eyes, or by hearing through ears, or by tasting through your tongue, or by gripping something by your hands, or by moving mobility through your legs. So think akasha, a broad space, and a bigger spark inside it, this is a soul. Then also think about a small spark, rotating spark mind. Then the rotating spark, it must be fixed in an orbit, that is mind, that becomes the intellect. Then it moves through determination and it executes in the form of action. So just there is a space, there is a bigger dot, there is a small dot that is rotating, that is fixed in orbit, that is moving, started moving, that is coming through your eyes, imagine. That is coming through your ears, that is coming through your nostrils, that is coming through your touch buds in the form of pores in the body, from the taste buds in your tongue, through your limbs,